Some of you have been asking for an overview, so I think I'm going to do that in this video. The scene you see here is a customized scene that I've created using a bunch of Unity assets. And I cannot upload this scene onto my repository, obviously, because it's made up of a bunch of paid assets. But it's the exact same game as what I've been showing you in my previous videos. We have the attacks, you know, all the transitions, rolling, sliding. We also have the axe. You know, it's the exact same game. Let me go to my previous scene that I've been working on. And if I play, okay, it's the exact same game, just with different looks. And by changing some of the assets, the camera, the lighting, some post-processing, you can achieve some looks that are completely different. I'm gonna have all the links below so you can see what assets that I've used. But let me say that you do want to be careful before you buy anything, because you're gonna be spending a lot of time customizing and changing, editing stuff until you get to something that you like. You're probably not gonna buy an asset and immediately get a scene that just looks perfect. I have a lot of red here in the background. I think that might be a little too much red. I need to fix that, but this is something that is just open to change. Will probably be updated later on. But overall, I'm happy with the looks. As you can see, I'm using the cartoon shader, again, from the Unity Asset Store. Now, let me talk about what's really important, what goes underneath. Okay, I'm gonna click on one of the characters. Where's my animator window? Okay, so here is the animator for the character, the main character. This animator controller is a state machine, and the entire game pretty much evolves around the state machine. I'm gonna play. So I consider each animation a state. So I'm walking right now. Here's a walking state. Go back to idle. We have the idle animation. So by using the animator controller, automatically each of the animation becomes a separate state. I could write my own state machine, but I like doing this because whenever I want to add an animation or edit a state, I can just look at each of the states and look at the abilities. For example, the idle has the idle ability. This doesn't really do anything. Let me go into the walking. Let me find a walk state. Okay, so the walk obviously has the move forward ability. This will make the character move forward. Without this script, the character is only going to play the walk animation without actually moving forward. This is a script that moves the box collider of the player forward. And let me see if I can find the jump. I kind of forgot where jump was. Okay, so here is the jump ability, jump state, and the jump ability here. So the animator controller here only decides which animation to play and which animation to transition to. And depending on the animation, we look at which of the abilities are included in the animation, and we simply update these scripts. So if I look at jump normal, the jump script, at a certain timing, we simply add force to the rigid body and make the player go up. So the whole process is first deciding what animation you want to use. You go to places like mixamo.com, or you order your own customized animations, or go to Unity Asset Store, anywhere you can get humanoid animations. Once you decide what animation you want to use, you go to the state and add a bunch of abilities to the list of the abilities that the animation is going to have. So for something like punching, obviously we're going to have the punching animation and some sort of an ability that detects collisions. So if I look at 1-2-3 combo number 2, we have the actual animation here, and then the script that detects collisions. We also have move forward, because you're slightly moving forward while you're punching, and the ground detector to detect whether, you know, sometimes as you're punching and you move forward, you might be stepping off the ledge and this will trigger you to fall or go into the fall animation. The whole point is looking at each animation as a separate state and not having to worry about anything else. So when you're punching in this animation, for example, you only worry about these scripts as well as the transitions, but mostly you only care about this certain animation or animation state. So if I pick up a weapon, for example, I'm gonna pick up an axe. So once you pick up an axe, you go into axe idle, and there's only a certain transitions that you can go from the axe state. You're not gonna go into a forward rolling state or sliding simply because there is no transitions. And with this kind of system, you can set up your states and transitions in a way that you want to design your gameplay. Or I could also add stuff like rolling and sliding or jumping. I don't have it with the axe right now, but obviously the jump from holding the axe is going to be very different from jumping from an idle position. So that's how I design my gameplay. Right now, things are not finished and I still have a lot more stuff to add, but you get the whole point. I can also throw the axe. Okay, once I throw the axe, I go back to the idle state, and from there I can do, you know, all the stuff that I used to do without the axe. Some of you asked for some projectile weapons or guns, rifles or pistols, stuff like that. For those kind of things, I'm just going to follow the exact same process. I'm going to have some sort of an animation that where if you're holding a pistol, for example, obviously you're going to go into a certain stance. So after you pick up a pistol, you go into that stance, and then from there you can go into some sort of a firing animation where you have some recoil and stuff like that. Or it could be a rocket launcher or anything, whatever the animation is designed for. And I can continue to use the same process and add more and more stuff on top of each other. Or I can also focus down on one animation at a time. And if there is an issue with some sort of a bug, I can focus down on an animation and just look at a certain sets of code, not having to worry about the other stuff. And that's going to help me fix the error a little more efficiently. Some of you have also expressed frustration with the recent videos where I'm not really doing anything, where I'm just refactoring some data, moving things around the subcomponent part especially. This is nothing more than tucking away some code into a separate script. The real point is just controlling the states, the animations, and the abilities. This is just a way to keep things a little more organized, because as I add more and more features, I'm going to have more and more scripts, and it's only going to get increasingly more difficult to keep things nice and clean. I've seen some indie game developers completely neglecting the idea of cleaning up or organizing. That could work if your game is simple enough, but in most cases it's not. In most cases you want to build something that kind of resembles your dream game, and it's going to be quite complex in terms of having player controllers, AI, different effects, you know, multiple things going on at the same time, and you're running at 60 frames per second. In those kind of games, it's very important to keep things organized, at least up to a point where, for example, if you come back from a long break, you might have a lot of things forgotten, just disappeared from your brain, from your memory. And if you've been following a logical process, it gets a lot easier to just look at a part of your project and then just continue with that process and continue where it left off. Versus if you have a bunch of spaghetti code, you're gonna be spending more time trying to remember things or trying to come up with some sort of a process, some note taking, whatever, to keep your head in line with that spaghetti code. So it's really important for you to at least have some sort of a logical flow that you use when you add new features or edit stuff. And my recent videos with the refactoring and everything, that's what it is. And once I'm done with organizing and cleaning up, once I feel like it's cleaned up enough to build more stuff on, then I can add stuff like, you know, all the stuff that I've been thinking about. Could be new weapons, new moving abilities or transitions. Basically, all the stuff that needed to be there in order for this to look more like an actual video game. I also plan on adding more updates to the AI. Right now, AI is just something really simple. Chase down the player and attack. Let me just show you. So AI goes to the player and start attacking, and player dies. It's very simple. But later I'm going to add, you know, more stuff like patrolling, maybe some social interactions, NPCs, some dialogues, stuff like that. And I could also expand to stuff like boss fights. For something like a boss NPC, that would be just comprised of a different set of animations, a different 3D model with different abilities. But the process would be exactly the same. You pick your animation and you pick your abilities. And as you update these abilities, the player, box collider, or whatever acts accordingly to the script. The only difference between the player and the AI is that if we look at the animator state again for the player or the subcomponent, we have manual input, whereas the AI doesn't have manual input. It has a separate script called AI. Both the AI and the manual input are scripts that control parameters, the parameters here. And these parameters control when you transition to a state. So from idle, for example, if you have move checked, then you go into some sort of a moving animation state, in this case, walking. Let me show you an example. I'm going to turn off AI for now. Go into the player animator. So depending on the transition index, for example, if I switch this to 1, okay, we get the transition that is based on this index. If I go to 2, okay. So the only difference between the AI and the player is which script controls the transitions. In case with the player, obviously it's the keyboard, whereas in case with the AI, we have a separate state machine that looks at the situation and decides what the AI should do. Okay, as I press the keyboard, you see the parameters changing. As for the AI, it's not the keyboard that changes these parameters, it's a separate AI script. So that's pretty much the entire overall process of how I'm writing the gameplay. I also like the visuals here, so every time I add an animation, I only care about one state, and then depending on what I want, I add a bunch of arrows or transitions, and then a combination of all these different animations and transitions leads to a character controller that you can play around with. Okay. And of course, you can also change the assets and make the game look completely different and do whatever you want with it. But the underlying mechanics, the code, the settings have never changed. Or they get updated over time, but changing the looks doesn't mean that you're changing any of the code. Okay, or I can also buy some animations from the Unity Asset Store and use the same code, but set up just a different transition, a different animation, add a different combination of abilities that I want for that specific animation, and you already have a different character with different moves. So I can have a whole different sets of combinations, AIs and bosses and different players that you can choose from. I haven't really decided exactly what I want to do. I just have a general picture in my head. And also I try to listen to the feedback as much as I can and make changes. I also make stuff as I go along. You know, it's just a overall fun experiment that I'm running. I'm just doing whatever I want. But the point is having some sort of a logical flow that you always return to. In this case, it's the animator controller. That basis rarely gets changed. And again, it's really important to keep things organized. the more you add, the more features and stuff that you add to your game, things are only gonna get more dirty. And every time things get too dirty, you have to take your time to, you know, clean things up and make things manageable. I know it's really boring to a lot of people. To me, it's fun. I like organizing things. I actually find joy in doing that. But you want to keep things clean enough so that even if you come back from a long break or something, you don't have to try to remember things. You just look at a project, a part of your project, and that reminds you of some sort of a logical flow. And for me especially, I'm running three different projects, and I find it crucial to have at least some sort of a process that I can always return to when things get too messy. And that helps clear my head better, keep things simple and nice, which is also going to help me focus more on later on the actual fun stuff. Right now, I'm just focused on building a sound base so that later I can take my mind off a certain process, because I know that even if I forget everything and come back, just by looking at a certain script, that's going to remind me of what I've been doing. I just follow one logical process after another. So knowing that, I can focus down on later on some 3D art or effects or whatever new stuff that I find interesting, and I can continue to add stuff to my game, and the entire process can be more enjoyable. At least it is for me. So that's it for this video. I only talked in general terms today because I wanted to keep things general. I didn't want to get into any of the specifics because that would take too much time if I go through everything. If you want any more details into a specific mechanic, some sort of a question that you'd like to be answered, you can always reach me on my Discord server. All the links are below, so you can go there and reach me and ask any specific questions. This project is also in a public repository, so you can download and try it yourself. You just won't have this customized scene. You'll have the default free scene that I'm working on publicly. But again, it's the exact same game with the exact same code. The looks, it's just the surface is just different. Okay, so thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.